The world is already filled with amazing creatures that look like they probably shouldn't even exist. Like a hippo, what is that? We just accept that this thing exists? Have you ever seen a hippo poop? It looks like it's pushing mud through a fan. But in recent years, scientists have decided to play mad scientist to see just how crazy of features that they could come up with. Humans have created totally new creatures that have never existed before, and some of them are mind-boggling. I mean, seriously, you won't believe that they actually exist. And before we begin, be sure to join my Discord and follow me on Twitch. Links are in the description. Okay, let's go. Here are five crazy living creatures created by humans. Number five are unkillable bed bugs. Have you ever heard someone say, "Sleep tight, don't let the bed bugs bite"? Well, some people think that it's just a saying, but these insects are actually real, and they can be nasty at the best of times. One female bug alone is all that's needed to climb into your bed and infest an entire house with thousands of offspring. Perhaps they get their secret powers from, and I'm not joking, feeding on the blood of people as they sleep. These pesky creatures are all out little Draculas. But what if I told you that these bed bugs hiding in mattresses around the globe today are not your ordinary garden variety bed bugs? In fact, they're super mutants, created by human beings like some sort of weird X-Men Stan Lee brainchild. Let me explain. You see, we know that bed bugs have been living in our mattresses and other furniture for at least 3,500 years, hiding nearby, waiting to bite our ancestors and now us. There are fossils of them dating back to when the Egyptians were building pyramids, but it's likely that they go all the way back to when we lived in caves. The species was extremely successful at feeding on their human roommates for all of that time, right up until the 1950s. That was when something bizarre happened to the bedbug kind. Human beings were finally fed up with these little guys and how much havoc that they were causing, so there was a large drive to use pesticides known as pyrethroids around the world. This wiped out most of the bedbugs for decades, until about 20 years ago. Suddenly, they started to show up again. They spread faster than ever before, and researchers wondered if there was something different about these bedbugs as opposed to the ones that had almost been completely wiped out. Well, as it turns out, just like every other science fiction monster movie you've ever seen, the chemicals that we used to kill them made a small number of these bedbugs stronger and stronger over the decades. Hiding in the shadows, mating. So much so that some are almost unkillable using normal pest control. By wiping out most of their population, the surviving bedbugs carried a genetic mutation that meant that they were immune to whatever we threw at them. The worry now is that as we try to use other chemicals to wipe out these growing threats of these biting insects spreading from home to home, that will only end up making them even more resistant, super mutant bedbugs, oh god. Think of them like teeny weeny armies of Wolverines and Deadpools, though not as charming as Hugh Jackman and Ryan Reynolds. Dreamy. Number four is human-monkey hybrids. God, I love good science gone crazy, which is why rumors of human-animal hybrids, and especially human-ape or monkey hybrids, have fascinated me for a long time. Especially chimps. Chimps will rip your face off. The idea that there are an entirely new species with the combined characteristics of animals and humans is both intriguing and terrifying. Most of these stories talk about vague whispers around university campuses and research facilities, like someone's created the dreaded ape man in a laboratory in the basement, or something like that. But while these stories are fun to share and discuss, most people think that such animals are unlikely until now. Yep, the good old march of technology that brought you your smartphone and the ability to taunt people from thousands of miles away has now brought a very real human hybrid to life. Well, a monkey-human, to be precise. Most researchers around the world wouldn't even attempt such a thing due to ethical concerns. But nonetheless, it was reported in 2019 that a team of researchers led by Professor Juan Carlos Ipsua Belmonte had traveled to China and created this exact animal. The official report suggests that the human monkey chimera was created by injecting human stem cells into a female monkey egg.
Father, what am I?
But where other attempts have tried similar things and failed, to the astonishment of researchers and the horror of the scientific community, it turns out that this time it worked. The researchers began to grow their very own monkey humans. When these reports first surfaced, the scientists involved claimed that they terminated the creature within just a few weeks so that it would never actually be born. But there is now increasing concern that, given the potential military benefits of creating human beings with the agility or even the strength of a monkey, perhaps even a primate at some point, that these experiments now continue behind closed doors. This begs the question, are these human-monkey hybrids out there? I hope not, because I've seen Planet of the Apes and I know exactly how this turns out. Number three are gigantic cats. As many of you know, I love little meow meows. In fact, I got two of them of my own. They're great pets, but have you ever wondered how big cats could actually get? I'm sure pet stores around the world would love to sell giant cats, but of course these animals don't really exist. Well, actually they do. And they're entirely the product of human intervention. For some time now, cat breeders have been taking lions, tigers, and other huge predatory cats and mixing them together. Unfortunately, not with some kind of teleportation technology like the fly, which would be equal parts cool and horrifying, but instead with the old tried and tested technique of romance, breeding these animals together to see what happens. The result has been several brand new cat animals that are significantly larger than anything that exists naturally. So your next question is, how big exactly? Well, to start, there's a liger, which is a cat that's a half lion and half tiger that weighs 922 pounds and is 11.8 feet tall when rising up on its hind legs. And this animal is called Hercules. When you see pictures of this big guy, what else could they have called it? To put Hercules' size into perspective, the largest tiger ever recorded was 771 pounds. Not only that, but Hercules the liger is reported to be able to run at up to 50 miles per hour and is now thought to be the same size as the huge prehistoric tigers and lions that used to prey on early mankind. To create these giant cats, breeders are continuing to experiment. This involves breeding together different members of the Panthera group of cats, tigers, lions, jaguars, and leopards. Whenever this occurs, they're given weird names, usually a combination of both parents. So there are ligers, tigons, liguars, leogers, leopards, tigards, jaguarpards, and my favorite, the half tiger, half jaguar called the Jagger. And believe me, it's almost impossible to avoid making moves like Jagger jokes here, but I'm gonna not do it. These gigantic cats can truly look bizarre. I mean, imagine a lion but with a leopard's spots, or a tiger with a lion's mane. Up until recently, it was assumed that these animals were all sterile and couldn't reproduce, but it's been discovered that some of them can pass on their unique genetics. This means that we could essentially create an entirely new viable species of genetic cats that could easily eat all of us. On second thought, let's just not do that, okay? Thanks. Number two are red glowing puppies. Yep, buckle up, this is a weird one. We've talked about human hybrids and accidental super bed bugs created by humans, but what happens when we start to give known species of animal brands new abilities? With the advent of genetic editing and manipulation through technologies like CRISPR, you're going to start hearing more and more about bizarre animals in the coming decade. For now, let's focus on red glowing puppies, or puppy to be precise, if that's not weird enough. His name is Ruppy, he's a beagle, and I'm sure by these pictures you'll agree he's adorable. But Ruppy's name is actually short for Ruby Puppy, and that's because he can glow red under certain situations. If you were to place him in a dark room and turn on an ultraviolet light, this would cause his skin to generate a deep glowing red off of its own. This was achieved by giving Ruppy the puppy genes from an animal just about as different as possible. The scientists, led by Byung Chun Lee at Seoul National University in South Korea, were able to give Ruppy genes from a sea anemone. Now, sea anemones are alien-looking predatory marine animals that often resemble a moving plant. When you see one, the last thing that you'd ever think of is a dog. Despite their strange appearance, they are actually related to the jellyfish. The idea of giving a dog some of the traits of such an animal from the sea is mind-bending. Nonetheless, it worked. These specific genes give the power of light to Ruppy, albeit under specific circumstances. Ruppy is seen largely as a proof of concept, where researchers will be able to give specific genes to animals to help understand diseases that affect human beings. Some are also looking at potentially more unethical scenarios, such as creating totally new creatures or bringing back extinct ones. Jurassic Park, anyone? Four more puppies were later produced, and by all accounts, they are now breeding them. Animals that have these qualities are called transgenic, as they possess the characteristics of more than one species at a time. This opens the door for all manner of animals with strange abilities. Listen, all I'm asking for is for a cat that has genes that allows it to sleep through the night and not get up at 3 a.m. and go meow meow and run around. If you have a cat, you know what I'm talking about. I just want to get a good night's sleep. And number one are primate pigs. When we think of hybrid animals, it's either something that looks like a combination of two other creatures, or, like Ruppy the puppy, has one trait from another animal. An ostrich with an elephant trunk. That would be cool. However, in 2019, scientists were able to create a living animal that looked normal but had a startling secret. This creature is kind of like the 007 of the animal world. It's a spy, no doubt. It blends in with the population, but when the time is right, it's ready to take out the villain with the bad accent and the eye patch. Okay, not really, but it is fascinating. I'm talking about the first ever primate pig chimera. That's right, a pig crossed with a monkey, in this case the crab-eating macaque, a species often found in Southeast Asia. To the human eye, the primate pig looks like a normal pig, but a DNA test would reveal that these carry the macaque genes. I mentioned earlier that scientists had created human-monkey hybrids, but what's special about this primate pig is that it was actually carried for a full term and was born alive. The main reason that this pig, or actually the two of them, were allowed to be born is that when human DNA is spliced together with an animal, there's a real concern that the resulting animal would be a legal person, that it would have at least part of a human brain. But these primate pigs sidestepped that issue by using monkey DNA instead. That meant that if the pigs survived, that there would be fewer ethical issues, though some would say mixing animals together like this is playing God and not okay. The researchers counter this by saying that if we keep experimenting with monkey pigs, we'll eventually figure out how to include human DNA without a problem. If we could figure out a way to stop human brain cells from growing in these chimera animals, then we would be able to grow pigs with human organs that could be used for transplantation. This would solve organ shortages, save lives, and make everyone smell of bacon. Of course, this is a hugely problematic area, and I'd love to know what you guys think in the comments. Cutting-edge science is fascinating, but how comfortable are you with creating such new creatures from scratch? It's all fun and game until your giraffe impregnates a dog.
Father, what am I?
That's all for this time. Thank you guys for watching, and remember to join my Discord and follow me on Twitch. Links are in the description. I'll see you guys next time. Peace out.